Okay, so hello everyone. Today let me show you this Fowler dial bore gauge, range 35 to 160 millimeters. I got this from Amazon 2 years ago, maybe, for about, if I'm not mistaken, $125. I'm going to use this to measure this thing. This is a vintage Bendix Westinghouse air brake compressor. Okay, so just to show you. Okay, so this is the thing that we're going to measure. These are the bores that we're going to measure. Okay, so the first thing that we need to know about a dial bore gauge is that it's not a measuring tool wherein you can just stick it in and then it tells you the exact measurement. It's not like a caliper or a micrometer wherein you can just do this, then it tells you it's 5.91. Okay, so we need to have to calibrate this with regard to the bore that we are measuring. Say for example on this bore. Now I know that this bore, the standard of this bore is, if it's imperial, it's 2 1/16 inches. If it's in metric, it's 52.39 millimeters. So I'm going to round it off to 52.40 millimeters. Okay. Now before we calibrate this thing, I'll show you. This is the measuring head. This range 50 to 160 millimeters. If you need to measure bores that is smaller than that, you just unscrew this, take this out. Okay. And this is it's got a range of, this measuring head right here has a range of 35 to 50 millimeters. So I'm going to place it. You notice there's a somewhat of a notch right there. Supposed to go there. It's to hug the measuring head, and this is all that's inside the stem of the dial bore gauge. Now we're going to have to align this, the middle, like so. See? And screw it in place like that. Now if we're going to measure this measuring head, we're going to need to measure use these anvils. This is 50, 45 for the 35 to 50 range, and these are the anvils for the 50 to 160 range. Okay, but we're going to measure a bore that's got a size of 52.40, so that's beyond 50. So we're going to put this back again. Okay, like so. Okay, very easy. Tighten it a little bit, not too tight. Now the next thing that we're going to do is to put our dial indicator mounted on the stem. Okay, now I like to position it in this way. Okay, so that way if I measure the bore, I can see the dial, unlike in this direction. Okay, I prefer to have it in this direction. Now when we put it inside the stem, okay, we loosen this a bit. We want to have the dial indicator already moving a little. Okay, so it's already moving, you can see that. Pay attention to this. This is 0. I like to put it on 1. This is 1 millimeter. Okay. Right. Okay, so now that we've got the dial indicator on our dial bore gauge, the next thing that we'll want to look for is the right anvil. So in this case, we're going to measure a bore that's 52.40. So this is 50. Okay. So we're going to put that there. But this is only 50, so we need washers. So that's why we have washers here. Okay. Now don't lose this. These are precision washers. This is 3 millimeter, 2 millimeter, 1 millimeter, 0.5 millimeters. Okay, I'll show you. These are not just ordinary washers, so don't lose it. See, exactly 3 millimeters, and this is the 1 millimeter, so exactly 1 millimeter. Okay, so now we have this 50 anvil. It's to measure 0.50 bore gauge. Now we're going to add it 2 millimeters, and we're going to put that there. This way, this is now set to 52, well, not set, okay, but just a rough estimate, 52 millimeters, 52.4, okay, so anyway, 52. So now the next thing that we're going to do is we want to have our micrometer. So now we have our micrometer, this range 50 to 75. We're going to put it to 52.40. okay, so this is 52.5, this is 52.4. okay, show you. Okay, so this is 52 and 52.40. I'm going to lock that in place like so. Okay, so the next thing that we'll do is, okay, just focus. Okay, 52.40. next thing that we'll do, we would want to put our, or place our micrometer on a vise or bench vise like so. Tighten it down, not so tight that it will distort the caliper. Just snug, just so it won't move. We wanted to do it this way because it's very difficult to do it with the micrometer on your left hand and the micrometer, the bore gauge on the other. Okay. Okay. So the next thing that we'll do is we're going to calibrate our dial bore gauge. This is exactly 52.40. Okay, so now we're going to calibrate our dial bore gauge to 52.40. We're going to stick it in between the micrometer, like so. See? And we'll see, if we're going to swing this back and forth, you see the dial where it stops. Okay, if I'll do it, it's going to go back. And if I will overdo it, it's going to go back. So where it stops, that's where we're going to put our seal. In this case, we're near. Okay. Okay, some more. We overdid it. Okay. We would want to have it as center and the micrometer as possible. See? Now we're exactly on zero. Okay, now this is the business end of the dial bore gauge. Okay, this nipple right here, if I'm going to press on that, see, it's going to move the dial indicator. Now put your attention here. If I'm going to put it this way, in this direction, so if we have that reading, this is exactly 52.40. now if you notice, there's a plus and minus sign. Should we stick this inside the dial, the bore that we're measuring, should the arrow point here, that's meaning that's minus 10. So that's basically 52.40 minus 10. So basically you have a bore measurement of 52.30. Conversely, this is plus. So if we're going to put it here, that is 52.40 plus 10, that is 52.50. And similarly, like so, that's plus 14, so 52.54. Okay, and like so, 52.60, 52.70, and so on and so forth. Okay, so now we're ready to take our measurements. Okay, so like I've said, I've already took some measurements on this thing. I'm going to do it again right now so I can check for repeatability. Okay, so we're going to measure it in this direction, the front, the top part, as well as on the bottom part, so that we can check for taper, meaning if the cylinder is something like that or like that, is bigger on top and smaller on the bottom, or vice versa. And we're going to check it this way so that we can check for out of roundness. Now, if you notice, there's a tape here. Now, on the bottom, I mean the top part, this is going to be my reference, wherein I will measure the, get my measurement for the top part of the cylinder, and this is my reference where I will take the measurement for the bottom part. Okay, so now we will take the measurement of the top part. As you can see, it's giving us a measurement of, okay, I'm going to have that reference 36. See, 36, 35, 36, 36, see, okay, so 36 now, 52.40 plus 36, let's check, it's 52.76, okay, so 52.76, okay, so now we're going to take measurement on the bottom part of the cylinder, so, okay, 35, 36, 36, 36, you see, 36, 36, okay, so 36, we are going to check again, our measurement is 52.76, so 52.40 plus 36 is 52.76, so we have no taper. Now we're going to check for out of roundness, okay, going to measure it in this direction, like so, okay, and the top part as well. Now that's 30, okay, so 30 30 30, okay, so we will check 52.70, so 52.40 plus 30 is 52.70, just the same as yesterday. We saw we have repeatability. Let's check the bottom part. 52.70 also. So this is the result from yesterday. This is the bore that we measured, bore cylinder number one, 52.70. So basically we've got an out of roundness of 0.06 and we have no taper. But I have also carried out some measurements on the piston. Basically you do that with a micrometer. I've got a piston to wall clearance to 52.76, 52.53. So, okay, so this is the smallest diameter of the measurement that I've got from the piston corresponding to this bore. So it's got a piston to wall clearance of 0.53. So that's considerable. I mean, that's a lot. And also on cylinder number two, basically it's got a very huge taper of 0.08, a piston to wall clearance of 0.53 with its corresponding piston. So basically I need to find parts, preferably an oversized 0.50 pistons and piston rings. So if you have any idea where I can find parts for this thing, I would greatly appreciate it. Please inform me. Now, before I end this video, I would like to show you this. I bought this for maybe 700-800 pesos. This got a range of 18 to 35 millimeters. Okay, so the Fowler has only got a range of 35 to 60, so this is smaller than 35, so this has a range of 18 to 25 millimeters. Now just the same with the Fowler, okay, like so, I'll count that down, okay, this stem right here has also its corresponding anvils. Now say for example we want to measure the diameter of this Conrad bearing. Now first first thing we need to do is to take a base measurement of this Conrad bearing so that we can calibrate the dial bore gauge. That's 28.70, okay, so 28.60, let's round it up to 28.5, so like so, we have, I don't know if you can see that, come on focus, you've got a corresponding 30, 34, 32, 30, 28, 26, so like I've said a while ago, just use the right anvil, so in this case 28. Okay, and then I will screw that on the measuring head like so, and then calibrate a micrometer to 28.50. okay, so 28.50. now do the same procedure with the own device. Okay, now so I have this calibrated to exactly 28.50. this, okay, just so I can show you, insert that there. Basically we only want to measure the side rear, not on the middle, okay, just on the side part. Okay, so it's giving us 18, okay, plus 18. So 28.50 plus 18 is 28.68. Let's check our, okay, so journal, Conrad bearing is 28.68. Okay, so same as yesterday. We will now check the diameter of the journal. So 28.50, so same as yesterday. So the diameter of the journal is 28.50, same with here, 28.50. Conrad bearing is 28.68. We've got a Conrad to journal clearance of 0.18 millimeters, and that's way beyond specs. Journal to Conrad bearing clearance is only 0.02 millimeters, maximum 0.05. So basically I also need to have this replaced. I need to rebore this to oversize 50. I need new oversized pistons and piston rings to 0.50 millimeters. So anyway, that's it. That's all that I can show you. Please, if you have any idea where you can buy parts for this air brake compressor, vintage Bendix Westinghouse air brake compressor, 7¼ cubic feet per minute. If you have any idea where I can purchase parts for this thing, please help me out. I would greatly appreciate it. So if you like this video, please subscribe and like. Thank you for watching. By the way, I'm going to say I do not advertise for this product or the micrometer. So that's all that I can show you. If you like this video, please subscribe and like. Thank you for watching.